100% on pack today. We had a couple of athletes who hadn't done much work on pack or enough, which Lucy had, done no pack work up until this camp at all, and probably done a little bit of pack work, but not for a couple of months, and I think not very much work on it. We know that pack's a very, very important skill. Peggy did a demonstration or had a chat with the coaches last night about how important pack is on bars now, for a couple of reasons. One, it gives you a CR of high to low one. Two, it's an easier skill to teach rather than like an overshoot, and it's a D value, so it's got high difficulty. And the third reason, it's really good to use in combination. So it's easy to connect out of an element on high bar and into another element on low bar. And because of that, it's really important that we learn it correctly. So we're talking about making sure that our pack is nice and high, nice and floaty, and catches, close towards a handstand position. Not right in handstand, but close enough. And anything below 30 degrees, which is, that's 45, 30 degrees about there, anything lower than that, it's going to have a 0.3 deduction. Okay, so our pack needs to be above 30 degrees. Now that also then gives us the ability to be able to connect it to a shaft and all that kind of stuff, which this is really like this one. Okay, so I wanted to chat a bit about it, because I know the coaches spoke about it a lot last night. Peggy, showed some great examples of some good pack connections and that kind of thing. But I wanted to show how I would teach it, and that it can be learned in, the basics of it can be learned in one or two sessions, an hour's work or 6 months, 2 days worth of 3 days. So just while they're looking up, are you ready to go? Do you guys want to back up? We'll start with the first one. Coaches, it's really important that when you're teaching a pack, that the gymnast has a solid flyway first, because the pack actually is a bit of a counter rotation, so it's like it's a kick and stop legs and the lower body going first. You don't want to get confused between that action and the flyaway action. Otherwise, you can end up coming back on the bar, the pack, or kicking over too far and getting too much rotation from the kick out of it or connect it. So I wouldn't really start, start the pack pause and that kind of thing until we know that they've got a solid flyaway or kind of like that's an important coaching thing, just so you know.
Alright. So
pack is just to help the gymnast understand how to stop their rotation and stop their legs while they're shoulders and so it's a little bit coach intensive. I'm just going to face this way because it's my better arm and I'm not sure for sure. I want to see the gymnast leave the bar, so it goes this important. When you leave the bar, you'll see a nice candlestick shape first. Okay, so chest down, hit in between shoulders and toes lift. Some coaches do teach pack by releasing their head very early, so then they can stop their feet by moving their shoulders faster. I don't necessarily prefer that technique. For a dish, I prefer just to leave the bar in dish and then extend halfway from the skill. So it's a little bit more aesthetically pleasing and helpful support on the low one. So we practice that shape first. Always on the low bar, because I think the low bar to the down is a good comparison from the high bar to the low bar. And it's much safer and easier to spot from the ground as much as you want.
Okay, so I like to see the gym's in this shape here.
I want her to drop her toes at the same time she releases her arms and moves her head down.
That's the whole thing.
Exactly the same drill, I'll show you one more time. We'll go this way so you can see hopefully. Head between shoulders, chest round, toes lifted, arms released, toes will drop back towards the ground. Hands on the floor. Always do a power motion first so you can feel that counter rotation and action. And drop to front support. Come down to front support rather than your pike, because that's where it's going to go to your legs up. Then you'll go to a solid circle with top.
You have priority.
Next group from there, go for three swings. Same action, tuck, kick out. I like the tuck, kick out action as it tells the gymnast timing of when to start the hip extension. Okay, so I'll show you one with Lucy. Three swings, tuck, kick out, same position, down to the handstand or close to handstand on the floor with a nice, with a small amount of lower back arch. Three swings, so one, I want to see chest in, between shoulders, two, and I'll slide my hand from my stomach to the thighs, capturing a very similar handstand position. Again, no front support. So yeah, what I'm looking for is I'm looking for that nice candlestick shape in the release. Even though it's in a tuck, you can still create the same shape from your shoulders to your knees, even though your feet are behind. Okay, that's an aggressive hip extension, and hip opening. quite close to anything. I'll just get Chloe to do one as well, just because they've only done those for 3 days, so I'll get her to do one, so then she'll be ready for it. She had done no drills at all, by other than pretty much these two drills. And then we went to the bar, went from swings, onto a mat. I was chatting to Josh earlier, and I know that when we were talking about it, that if your gymnast is scared, you can set up decks on the other side of the client here to replicate a low bar and go swings to there for the pack first. But as those guys are pretty light, and I was happy with their drill on the floor bar, I was happy to go straight to the bar. So you can progress the pack pretty quickly if, you know, if the gymnast is. Yeah. If you're able to spot the gym as well, then you'll trust that that'll be okay. Alright, we'll go from 360 to the mat. Again, I'm just going to have my back to you. Sorry, I prefer to spot on the other side, but just while I'm still learning, I've got one. When I'm spotting her, you'll see that I put my front hand on her chest in the swing, and that's to show, like, that's to show her the position I wanted to make just prior to the release. I feel that's a good cue. We should do a cast, three swings. Head between shoulders, just release, and then do a pack drill. She'll do exactly what she did just down there, probably straight legs. And the progress is that quick. It doesn't take very long to work. You get puffed. So I'm pushing your chest down, chest down, chest down. So pretty nice, pretty good sport. You would have noticed that I haven't asked them to do anything other than block on the bar and then go down to their feet. Originally, when I first started teaching it, I tried to make them go to like front support or straight to the bar straight away, but I much prefer going to that block position now, because then that gives good support. They can feel that they're strong in handstand. And when you go straight to the bar, sometimes the gymnast wants to bend their elbows straight away because they're not sure if they catch yet. So I really like that strong position of block on the bar. Gets the bar moving, and it's quite a good step in the process. So yeah, Lucy only did that for the first time the other day, which was really good. And that was a really, really good step into being able to connect. Like you would have seen when she caught how high her legs were, the position of her body. Yep, can everyone see how she also had to open her hips aggressive to stop the rotation? Yes? No?
Yep.
Can see it? Thumbs up if you can.
Yep.
Thumbs out if you can't. Good, we'll find some things. We'll do the same thing for Chloe, three swings, and back. And on chest, knees bent even more forward. One, two, this one. Probably a little bit more rotation, but still a pretty good solid catch position. So 45 degrees, there'd be enough room there to go to a tomahawk. Chloe, we might move in front of that before we go to the front. Coaches, when I'm spotting, I'm just spotting it like a real flyweight, hands on back and belly. And then as they rotate, I just slide my hand down their stomach onto their thigh to help control the rotation of their legs. And it's good to practice, obviously, down on the ground, and then you know your hands are right anyway. So it's not a difficult skill to spot ball. It's much easier than, say, like a stall up, which was doing something. Last time I think they were a little bit more forward. Yes. When it's like that, and it's strong onto the bar, we just went, okay, well, that's nice, let's move on. So I took the mat off. As you can see, I prefer initially from, swing, just because it's a bit easier than having to worry about the handstand and the bail. That means they can only focus, then they can focus only on the pack, rather than trying to think about 7 million things at once. And also it's good then also to learn it from that, because if you shat, it's going to come from the swing anyway. So if you've got it from swing first, then learn it from handstand, then you can do it from anywhere. Which is good. All right, I'm just going to leave Sasha there for a minute. Just aim with the grip function, or actually going to win. That's a joke. Right, they laughed at me more this week, I promise. Same thing, three swings, then to the bar. I'm going to stall her position in the catch a little bit, and then she'll go through and keep casting. Yeah,
very nice fashion.
I would essentially extend the lunge a little bit past the bar and have to get it back.
Quite nice.
I was pretty happy with that. If the timing's out a little bit, don't stress too much. But just a comment.
Now, even though, okay, she just needs proprioception work for where the low bar was, but that technique that she used where she stalled out her legs is ideal because they get up to 30 degrees before support with no deduction. If they do 35 to 40, it's a 45, it's a 1/10 deduction, and then below 45 is a 3/10 deduction. So you want to learn in that support phase, you get 30 degrees before it's a deduction. And it's, as it turns out, it's the best degree to connect a shaft path. So that's where it's all going. So I actually really like that technique because she was like 10 degrees. It was beautiful.
The other thing I thought Peggy was going to say, that you would notice when her backswing was around bar height. We had a discussion yesterday. I didn't even know this rule until yesterday. But after you catch a shaft, you have to be able to swing to bar height at the back for no deductions. I didn't even know that existed until yesterday,
yep.
So thank you, Peggy.
Yep.
Doing it from swing here is probably not a bad idea, so then you can make sure that they're swinging high enough. And I know it's not as relevant coming, you know, out of a shaft, you would tuck differently, but being able to pack from a horizontal swing would be good.
One more, I think Chloe can do one, just so Chloe can show you one to the bar, because it is a new skill for her, and then everyone can do it. And then, for session,
and then I'll get Sasha to show a pack to toe on circle, which is the next next progression that I'll use after this. Sasha's is probably a little bit lower, and I'd say her technique might have disintegrated a little bit because we were competing pack and while squatting from the ground and that kind of thing. So it's not as fresh, so it might be a little bit lower, but she's still working on a connection. So that's where we want to see the pack get to, you know, as soon as we've got it from handstand off the swing. That would be the next thing. We only had probably 25 minutes on bars by the time we got the grips off. In two sessions to get that, that's huge. You know, in another 2 weeks, 2 months, that's going to be awesome. Support because I remember last time we did it was a little bit bent up in the kit. So we'll try one to kit now and hopefully it's the same support. Sasha always performs well when people are watching. If you guys could all sit in my gym all the time, that was... So anyway, keep casting handstand, pack, toe on circle. The first set, keep handstand, pack, toe on circle. So just a straight leg soul circle. Okay, if you don't make your fishing line, jump it around, you can just jump it. Hands body method that I used before. Score the length of this as well. Okay, we're going to see when we're talking about stalling the legs or not. I felt as soon as I'd had her body, I felt her feet drop straight away. So it'd probably be worthwhile me spending a bit more time with Sash doing some of those just stall drills. But we'll give it one more try.
One Sash.
Okay, I'll say out loud my corrections.
Yeah.
I'm asking her to bottom the bar a little bit more, and she comes down from her tap because she had a little bit too much swing. And then at the top of your pack, stop your feet. Weird giving a correction to a gymnast, but now. Later, they've missed them. Okay, so it's almost down, bars bouncing up, beating on the third, on the second down. Does that make sense? Yeah? Cool. And then from there, so I'm preaching down to everyone. From there, the next step I'll go would be pack to toe on top, and then pack to shut. But that's it. Pack in 2 days.
Thanks.